Hi guys, David Kwan here. So in another blog, I mentioned that, you know, I talked a lot about how playing Binary Domain reminded me of playing Vanquish. And then I kind of compared those two games together in that blog. But I never actually talked about, like, the actual Binary Domain. And I wanted to actually make a video talking about Binary Domain because it's a game I really, really enjoyed playing. Even though, like I mentioned in the other blog, the gameplay of Binary Domain is pretty basic, cookie-cutter, just third-person shooting action. Doesn't have anything unique to actually talk about that much. The one unique thing is the voice command thing. I play that game with my little headset on, and yelling commands to non-playable characters on the screen, going like, "Hey, you, rush!" or "You, regroup!" Or, you know, just yelling things at the TV screen, because one of the things they implemented in Binary Domain is voice command, so that was unique. Half the time it didn't work, half the time it would register me saying as something else, so they obviously have a lot more to improve on with that technology. It was neat, and it's interesting how they also try to implement that into, like, story sequences where you can actually respond to the character kind of saying something to you. It was neat, it was interesting, but it's because the technology was kind of, I mean, for me, I don't know if it's that much better. I mean, I played on my PS3 with the headset. I don't know, I feel like a thing like that would definitely feature Kinect, and I am not sure if it's any better on Kinect on the PS3 with the headset. Like I said, it worked about 70% of the time, but 30% of the time it would not register, or it would have me register as saying completely different than what I've actually said. Sometimes I didn't say anything, and then my character would be like, "Fuck you," and then I'm just like, "I didn't say that," or like, "Shut up," and then it's like, the other character's like, "What?" And then, you know, so it's interesting. One of the coolest thing on that mechanic is what you say, or how much your characters like you, your other characters like you, or how much they hate you. That makes them less prone or more prone to following your orders. So I thought that was a really cool mechanic. If the technology worked as it should have, it would have made the experience that much better. But it's kind of like I said in the blog, it's kind of gimmicky. So it's, even if it was not there, it would not have made a big difference in me liking the game or not liking the game. That's not why I like the game so much. I just fell in love with the premise of the story of the game. Majority of that does depend on the storytelling. I mean, I just love the whole the setup is that, you know, humanity survived global warming pretty much. The whole planet was flooded, and then the survivors built cities on top of that. But because the human population, most of it died out because of the global warming. The thing that happened once the world is flooded, they had to rely on robots to rebuild cities. And one corporation, I forgot the name of it, it's been a while since I played Binary Domain, but one American corporation became the corporation to advance robotics in the world. So now robots are used everywhere as maids. If you watched like any of the animated Matrix things that they did, like before there was a whole war between machines and humans, how machines were used, like there were humanoid machines that they use as servants or for services. It's kind of like that in Binary Domain currently. You know, there's a lot of machines that just are used for human purposes and for things of that nature. And there is a whole ethical dilemma with robotics. That's why there's a whole different console, like a military console, on robotics. And you, as a character, you play any one of these characters that are in that console to make sure that robotics doesn't threaten the end of humanity. You start at the premise is that there is a report of this. Well, in the beginning scene is this guy, this prime minister, or the guy in the robotics company, gets killed by someone who looks, talks, and is pretty much human, but is actually a robot. So that goes against the international treaties of, because it's making a robot that looks like, that passes off as a human, is illegal. So the whole premise is trying to figure out, well, who's doing this? And they figure out, you know, they deduce, they assume that it's the Japanese corporation in Japan that must have made robots that look like humans. So they must go in there, figure out what's going on, and stop them. And then, so most of the time, you're just trying to get into the corporation itself. And then the plot just keeps moving forward in that direction. And I really enjoyed how the character relationships develop, because at different parts of the game, you can choose which characters to be in your squad. And then you can have different interactions with them with the voice chat system, like I mentioned, which I thought was really well done. The writing is not that sharp, but it's just really enjoyable. Like, it's just kind of just immerses you into the environment, which I thought Binary Domain really did a good job of. And part of the thing that really helped it, which also, I really enjoy the graphics of Binary Domain. I know, maybe it's just my bias. Seeing something that's not made with Unreal Engine, like, excites me now. I don't know why. I'm so sick of Unreal Engine that anytime I see it, it's like, oh, this is not Unreal. This is exciting. This looks awesome. Even though Binary Domain is not like the best looking game out there. It's kind of like, it's just kind of cookie cutter in terms of like graphic fidelity, but it still looks pretty great. The setting is unique. In terms of the usage of the engine, though, I am biased, because I mean, Spec Ops: The Line had some fantastic environments, and that was using the Unreal Engine. So it's total bias here, but the game does look really great, so it really helps you to immerse in that experience. There's kind of a monotony that happens with the environments later on, because it kind of feels like, too much, but there needs to be a little bit more diversity. But that's the thing that immerses you. One of the coolest things about Binary Domain are the boss fights. They're not very fun to play, but they're just really cool, just because the bosses you fight in this game are pretty unique. They're just, I mean, they're robots, and they really went all out to make the most different kinds of robots there are. There's a gigantic robot that you fight in the beginning. There's a spider-like robot where you have to attack its legs. There's a robot that like rolls on wheels. There's a robot that hangs on the ceiling and is kind of like a rip-up of a Resident Evil monster. All kinds of robots that you fight, which is awesome. A lot of great boss fights. The hardest one I thought was like fighting against this super gigantic gorilla robot. Because it's not even that big, but it just jumps around everywhere and throws things at you. A lot of crazy things in there. A lot of crazy enemies, which was really great. The plot twist was fantastic. I really, really enjoyed it. And this is like, I've spoiled a lot of this story already. But the big plot twist, of course, is that like the love interest of the protagonist and Dan is actually its offspring of robot and human mating together, which just blows my mind. That happened. I knew like she couldn't be trusted. At the same time, I really grew to really like Faye, the character, and I really enjoyed how they two kind of came to like each other. Even though they have the stereotypical racist views of each other, they came to rely on the camaraderie of each other and just kind of grew to become fun. And then there's this whole plot twist of like, and then there's this whole ethical question of like, how much machine is too much, and are all machines evil? It doesn't delve too much into that ethical question, but like it's mentioned there, which I thought was pretty awesome. I mean, you have this fantastic premise of a world that survived global warming, and now you're going deeper into the ethics of robotic development and the AI development, which, you know, is kind of like the realm of Ghost in the Shell and the Matrix and stuff of that nature, which I thought was fantastic. And for a video game of this sort, I totally did not expect that. I just expected, especially judging from how stereotypically, like, just the characters are just so, like, you know, just so cliche and typical. I did not expect, like, a full, pretty deep story behind it, and I was really surprised at that. And I, like, literally, like, cheered so strongly when I, you know, at that moment when Dan fights Faye hand-to-hand combat, and then Dan points the weapon at Faye, and then fires, and I was just like, he tricked him. He didn't actually kill her. And then the scene turns into that being the case, and I was like, yes! Yes, I cheered so hard for that. I don't even know why, but I really come to grew attached to these characters, which is a great thing when a video game does that. And that's why I was saying, like, I grew to really become fond of Binary Domain more than I would ever of Vanquish, even though Vanquish gameplay wise is such a stronger game. But Binary Domain, because of the immersive nature of the premise, the graphics certainly helped, and then the little moments that happened with the gameplay and storytelling, it just made me so involved in Binary Domain, and I really wouldn't mind if there was a sequel to Binary Domain, and I would probably grab that in a heartbeat just because I had such a great experience with Binary Domain. And it does set itself up for a sequel really well with the epilogue ending that it has, so I'd be totally down for that.